Every year on the 4th of May, the Netherlands commemorates all those civilians and military who died or were murdered during the Second World War and the Holocaust in conflicts and peace operations. 75 years have passed since the end of the World War II, and few men and women who fought and survived are still alive. Their passing makes it more important than ever to remember them and others and to never forget what they fought for, what they lived through, and what kind of future they wanted for their children. The Dutch community in Auckland and Lucy Powell of the Veterans Organization organize a yearly commemoration at the Dutch monument in Parnell Rose Garden in Auckland. This year, Honorable Minister Ron Mark and Member of Parliament Marja Lubeck and myself were supposed to speak. We adapted a commemoration in light of COVID-19, and on behalf of us, Dutch Honorary Consul Sake Hitman will lay a wreath. This year, on the 5th of May, the Dutch also celebrate 75 years of freedom. Freedom cannot be taken for granted. It requires maintenance and active citizenship. It requires respect for human rights, human dignity, and the rule of law. History has taught us that we all have a responsibility, a role to play to defend freedom and to stand up against injustice. Let's celebrate 75 years of freedom and continue to work together to ensure freedom worldwide, especially now the COVID-19 virus creates so many challenges to our freedom.
Both my parents lived through wartime, my mum in Holland as a young girl, and my dad in Indonesia, where as a young boy he lost his father in the war camp. Now, it has been said that time heals all wounds, but I don't agree. Over time, scar tissue covers the wound and the pain lessens, but the pain always remains. It was 60 years after the end of the war that I saw my dad cry when confronted with some pictures of that war camp. I know it left an everlasting scar on his life. That's why it's so important that on this day of remembrance, we dedicate our commitment to always remember the suffering. As a four-year-old child in Holland, I received this mug. At the time, it was to celebrate 25 years freedom in Holland. It has now been 75 years since the end of the war, and we honour those who died so that we would have our freedom.
Kia ora tātou. Nā mai haramai, haramai. Tēnā koutou katoa. This year, we mark the 75th anniversary of the end of the Second World War, a significant day in history on which our brave sailors, soldiers, and airmen secured our nation's freedom alongside our allies and our friends. In the 15 years following the end of the Second World War, more than 23,000 Dutch people emigrated to New Zealand. Most came independently, but several thousand came under an assisted immigration scheme agreed to between the New Zealand and Dutch governments. Amongst these immigrants were many war veterans, both former members of the Dutch Armed Forces and the Dutch Resistance. Many had been through terrible and traumatic experiences in the service of their country. In 2001, the New Zealand government decided to make a $30,000 ex gratia payment to all New Zealanders who had been prisoners of the Japanese. Dutch war veterans were specifically included in that scheme. Dutch immigrants have made a tremendous contribution to New Zealand society in a range of fields, including agriculture, sport, business, and the arts. The way in which so many Dutch war veterans have been able to build new lives in New Zealand following their dreadful wartime experiences is a testament to their resilience, their strength of character, their determination, and their endurance. And we would like to think their solid commitment to their new home, New Zealand. Ka mo mahara tono tātou, ki rātou, lest we forget.